How's it going? My name is Jay and welcome to the channel. Today we're back here in Planet Zoo in Sanikov Land. Now, for those of you who are new here, Sanikov Land is my current project in Planet Zoo. We're working on creating this really large modern zoo in this lovely lush tropical environment featuring animals from all different continents. If that does sound good to you, please consider hitting the subscribe button to follow along for more of our Planet Zoo content. And of course, like today's video if you did like today's video. Now, what are we doing today? Well, today we're continuing our Australasian section with quite possibly one of the absolute cutest new animals that we have, which is of course the koala. Now, the koalas in the game are just the absolute best. They're so cute and so tiny and they're just so lovely. And they're one of my favorite things about this new pack. When it comes to this new pack, honestly, the animals and the quality of the animals has been tremendous. Like, genuinely, I'm so impressed and consistently impressed with the quality of all the animals and their new behaviors, especially with the koala, which you'll see in today's cinematics. They spend so much of their time up in the trees and climbing and, you know, just being koalas, which is great because animals like koalas and, you know, other small arboreal type animals rarely actually come to the ground. They spend a lot of their time up in the trees, and it is absolutely great to see that Frontier has taken the effort to make sure these animals do spend a lot of their time in the trees and climbing around, and it is nice to see that. So what we're doing is we're continuing the Australian trail that we've kind of created here. It's a little bit of a gallery, and each section will feature a little bit more of the Aboriginal artwork that Frontier has included in the game. It is really, really great artwork. I talked a little bit about it in the last episode, so if you want to hear a bit more of an in-depth kind of deep dive into kind of the significance of Aboriginal cultures and native cultures to just conservation and wildlife and stuff like that, do check out the last episode. It was quite an interesting discussion to be had, I think, and I found it quite interesting in general. But today we'll talk more about the animal itself. Now, I like I said, I really love the koala. It is a very, very cool addition to the game. It definitely fills in another niche that we have been kind of missing in the game, mainly the small marsupials. The only other animal I can think of that was kind of in a similar niche was probably the red panda. Of course, that's not a marsupial, but it kind of fit in a similar niche in terms of small arboreal animal. But even then, the koalas are such unique animals that I think they would definitely want it to be included into the game, and I am so happy we have them. Here we're building them a relatively small habitat. I wouldn't say it's small for the koalas, it's just small relatively speaking to my other habitats, because the koalas themselves are tiny. And because we only are including three koalas here. Koalas aren't super social. You don't have, like, you know, huge herds of koalas. You just have a few of them together at most. In fact, a lot of them spend a lot of time on their own. They're just not super social. So even compared to the other small animals we've had in the park, like the lemurs, the capuchins, because they're such social animals and they live in big, like, corrals of so many animals, their habitats do tend to be a bit larger. But of course, because the koalas are not that social, we're going to keep them in a smaller habitat. But it is going to be a habitat filled with enrichment for them, a lot of climbing space, loads of these new eucalyptus feeder trees, which I love. I just put them down right now. These look great. I love that the koalas make full use of them. And I just think it's really, really cool. We are also going to be adding in lots and lots of climbing structures for the koalas, for them to be able to move not just from tree to tree, but throughout the habitat without having to get onto the ground. Koalas don't spend a lot of time on the ground. They do a little bit occasionally, but it is something they do try and avoid for the most part. Now here, I just put down a hammock. The koalas don't, like, lay in the hammock or anything, but they can use it to traverse the habitat, which is pretty cool. I didn't record them doing it, but if you look at the traversable area, they can definitely access it, and hopefully I'll catch them doing it at some point so that I'll be able to film it for you guys. But yeah, here I'm getting started on the climbing frames that will be kind of traversing the whole of the habitat, allowing the koalas to move from one part of the habitat to another. And it's going to be relatively simple compared to some of the other builds we've done. It's just going to be using the standard climbing pieces that we have in the game, these thin wood pieces. I think the simplicity honestly really works and it looks really nice when it's all put together. But yeah, while we're putting together all this, how about we dive into today's species profile for the koala? Now, for all of you who are new to the channel, we do a species profile every time we do a new animal habitat on Sanikov Land, where we talk a little bit more about the animal, their ecology, learn a little bit more about them because of course this is Planet Zoo and the animals are the stars of the show. So I'll just get the species profile for the koala up on screen now. And oh my god, look at that adorable face and that nose. Oh, it's so, so lovely. Now, the koala, or Phascolarctos cinereus, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. To be fair, with a lot of these scientific names, I don't know if anyone can pronounce them right. But one cute thing you might notice is the word arctos in the scientific name. Arctos, of course, refers to bear, and a lot of people call the koalas koala bears. They're not, of course, bears, they're marsupials. But it is an interesting note that it is mentioned in the scientific name itself. Now, unfortunately, they are listed as vulnerable in the IUCN list, the red list. That is due mainly to habitat loss. There are a lot of diseases that affect them. Chlamydia is one of them. They get pneumonia very easily as well, which is really unfortunate. But a lot of the areas koalas lived are protected now. As you might remember, earlier this year there was those really awful Australian wildfires. Those were really, really bad, and those definitely took a huge toll on the koala population. But in Australia there is an effort to bring these guys kind of back up to speed in terms of their population, and a lot of zoos, not just within Australia but around the world, are definitely assisting in that goal to kind of protect koalas and other Australian animals. And when it came to the Australian wildfires, there were a lot of relief efforts for wildlife as well. And they did get a decent amount of support as well during those times. But of course, they are always more open to, you know, getting more support. So if you're interested, do look up wildlife relief for Australia, for, you know, the bushfires and not just that, just Australian wildlife conservation in general. So that is definitely worth checking out if you're interested. As far as size goes, these guys are the largest arboreal marsupial. They get up to about 15 kilograms, which is pretty hefty. They are chunky boys. And they get to about 80 centimeters long, so about 0.8 meters. Females are about 20% smaller, I believe, 25% smaller than the males. The males are slightly larger. Their habitats are generally kind of like open forest, woodlands, riparian areas, some slightly more arid areas as well. But again, they spend most of the time on the treetops themselves. They live to about 20 years in the wild, and their diet is almost exclusively eucalyptus leaves. I believe they've noted that koalas have a selection of about 600 different types of these, but they tend to favor about 30 or so of these eucalyptus leaves. Not 30 individual leaves, 30 types of leaves. Now, let me get up some interesting facts about the koalas. Now, the koalas actually have opposable thumbs on both their hands and feet, which really help in their climbing ability, so they'll be able to climb really, really well. Fun fact about their hands, actually, koalas actually have really similar fingerprints to humans, and there's this commonly told story about how they can actually be confused at crime scenes because they have such similar fingerprints to humans. Which brings up an interesting thought. What kind of crime scene has both human and koala fingerprints? Because I want to know, that's crazy. But yeah, that's a cool fact. Here's another really interesting thing. Their whole lifestyle of eating the eucalyptus leaves is really quite strange because eucalyptus leaves are toxic, like really toxic. And koalas eat up to a pound of them, or about half a kilo, wait, is that 2 kilograms? Nearly 2 kilograms of them a day. No wait, that's wrong, half a kilogram. It's one of those, but it's about a pound basically. And they eat so much of these, and it takes a lot of energy to break down the toxins and stuff like that. And the leaves themselves are not that nutritional, so they don't have very much energy content. So after eating these leaves, they have to spend most of their day asleep to kind of conserve that energy. Which is crazy. Like, imagine eating something that makes you so tired you just need to sleep all the time. which is pretty cool. They do have a very unique gut in that sense, because of course they're designed to digest these leaves specifically, but it's not very energy efficient. One more thing is that they're really not very social animals. They spend maybe less than 15 minutes a day socializing. They spend most of their time alone, chilling, and really they're not that fond of other koalas. They're very vocal animals. You might have seen some videos online of them making these really loud grunting sounds to kind of ward off any other koalas or even people. They're just kind of little grumpy dudes, really, as cuddly as they look. Which is one of those things, just like, oh, it's such a shame that they're not social because they're just so cuddly looking. Like, you'd expect a cuddly looking animal to be, like, all for the cuddle puddles and hanging out with other koalas, but eh, apparently not. But yeah, that is the fact for the koalas, and let's go back to the video itself and I'll talk a little bit about what I'm doing. Once again, very simple habitat. I just put down some rocks as a backdrop around the back, and now I'm putting down some plants. A few of these tree ferns just to kind of pad out the enclosure with some foliage, and a few of these new century plants, I believe they're called, the ones that look a little bit like aloe vera plants. They look really, really nice and really lend a really nice kind of arid feel to this habitat, even though it wasn't supposed to be super arid. It just looks really nice. And as you can see, the climbing structures are mostly complete as well. I put down a little feeder. I also put down a few enrichment items just while we're talking just now, including the wind chimes, is that what those are called? And the mirror mobile, on one of the platforms. That's one good way of getting your animals climb more, is to put enrichment down on these platforms. Not food enrichment, because the keepers need to access food enrichment, and if you put them a bit high up, it'll be a bit difficult for them to reach. But if you put down just kind of toy enrichment on these climbing structures, the animals will be more likely to climb them. Now here I am just including a roof structure on this on the back here. The roof is not going to cover the whole thing. It's just on the back so the koalas can climb their way out of the back of the habitat. And on the front you may notice that it is pretty easy for the koalas to escape. So off screen I also added a little bit of a second railing just so the koalas can't climb onto the guest areas and waddle their way out of the zoo, which would be kind of probably not the best for the koalas. They're not exactly, you know, the most like efficient at escaping predators or anything like that, so probably not a great idea for them to wander off into a zoo filled with, you know, apex predators. But here's the roof almost complete. Of course there's a little bit extra roofing where the staff area is. There's a little bit of stuff that I do here just towards the end where I kind of tidy up the roof structure a little bit and get in a few extra things to make it look a bit nice. But that is pretty much it for today, guys. This is about the end of the episode. We'll have some cinematics in about a minute or so you guys can see our lovely koalas exploring their habitat. They are so adorable, so definitely stick around for that. Just want to say, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. If you'd like, please do join our Discord server, link will be in the description. We're currently running our first Planet Zoo challenge, where we're kind of challenging you guys to build a themed entrance for your zoo. And once that's all done, I'll be featuring the submissions on a YouTube video of them of its own, so you guys can check out all of the cool builds that everyone's done. But feel free to join that, it'll be a lot of fun, and I think it'll be a great way to get some inspiration if you're, you know, finding it a bit tough to get building and stuff like that. So definitely go check that out if you're interested. Otherwise, the Discord server is also just a fun place to hang out and chat about Planet Zoo, maybe get, again, more inspiration for your builds, or share builds you've done in the game already. So yeah, feel free to go ahead and join that if you want. If you did like today's video, of course, give it a like. And leave a comment down below, tell me what you've been thinking of the Australian pack, what you've been thinking of this Australian section of Sanakovland as well. And yeah, that's about it, guys. So again, like the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below. Subscribe, of course, for more Planet Zoo content. And as always, I will see you in the next one on Wednesday. Bye, guys.